Hey guys, Nick again here with another video for you. This is going to be how to play Wish You Were Here by Pink Floyd, one of my favorite songs. This one, everybody knows this song. It's been on since the dawn of rock and roll, I think. No, it's actually been on the charts for over like 40 years. But definitely one of the best songs in rock and roll. Very simple song, bunch of major chords. A nice little lead in there too, that's just one of my favorite leads to play. It's got so much soul in it, nice and slow with a lot of bends too. So stick around and we'll walk through it here shortly. Alright, so intro and main part of the song, gonna be the verse. Here we go, it's G. I'll hold my G like this. I know some people hold it like this, but I don't like that myself. I like the real G, it just sounds better to me. So you can do the old eagle claw. All right, if you remember Phoebe on Friends, the eagle claw, that's gonna be G, all right? So G, what we're gonna do is strike the first string on the G chord. And then we're gonna open the second string with a hammer on the second. All right, so it's gonna be like this. Okay, and then you're gonna hit the third string open. And then hold down the third string second fret. So it's gonna be like that. Get a better view of that here, let's see. I just strike the bottom four strings. So it's gonna be like this. And do a little walk down, okay, so you got that. Well, not really a walk down, but it's like a, I'll show you. Up to the fourth string, so strike. After you do that first part, you're going to strike, you're going to keep your index finger where it is on the second fret third string, and then you're going to go up open. All right, so it's here. Let's see if I can get this in the picture. Here we go. So it's third string, fourth string open, third string again, and third string open. All right. All right. All right. So that's basically it for the first part with a minor variation on the third and fourth part of that. Okay. Third and fourth time you play that. So here we go. I'm just going to play it. So there's the walk down. So basically, on the third and fourth time, you're going to go. You're going to strike the third, where the index finger was on that first part. It's going to be third string, second fret. And then it's going to be open. And then walk down, second string, second fret. And then that open as well. So. So let's see if I can get it on here. So basically right here. Okay. All right. But that's while holding the G structure. It makes it easier if you can do it also. Like this. Thank you. when I go. Alright, that's when it kicks into the actual strumming. So, the last part was a walk down. Alright, and then I go. With the last one you were on, with the index, it would be 2nd string, 2nd fret. Hold it and pull off. Okay, and then into G. Alright, so all in all, here's what we got. So after it does that, we'll go from the pull-off and show you that. Into C.
So you think you can tell.
D.
Heaven from hell.
C.
Blue skies from G. Can you tell a green? From a cold steel rail, C. Smile from a veil, A minor. Do you think you can tell,
G?
Did they get you to trade,
D?
Your heroes for ghosts, C. Hot ashes for trees, warm air for a cool breeze, cold comfort for change. Did you exchange a walk on board in the war for a lead role in a cave?
Alright, so then you got the chorus. Back to C. After you play that last part, C. Here we go again.
How I wish you were here. We're just two lost souls living in a fishbowl.
Verse, all right. So it's going to be C D C G D C A minor G. All right. Okay. So the really cool lead part. I'm going to slow that down just a little bit so you can see the mechanics of it. So, the way I play this song, it plays with this part. It's in between that. You'll see that as I'm playing this song, I'm kind of playing that along with the lead. And I think that's kind of how it's meant to go. There's probably two different guitars in the original song, but you can play it with both parts as a part of the lead, if that makes sense. So, check this out. All right, so we got the main part that's like this, right? And that's what I start to go into the lead. So we go like that. And then right here, I'll take my ring and slide from the fourth string, 2nd to 4th fret. And then hit my index up or on the 5th string, 3rd fret. So it's going to go like this. And then hit the 5th string, 5th fret. and then back down to the fourth on your middle, and then back down to lid off of that ring. So it's going to be like this. All right, so again. And then you take that ring and you walk down, do a pull off, and then an open. Pull off from the fourth to second, then open. And then that's going to be an open third string. All right, so what we got so far. All right, and then you're going to do a. You just do basically a slide from the first to second. And then open, double strike on the second, on the third open string. All right, so what we got here. All right, so you got that part. And then you're going to go back to that part I was telling you about that's integrated into the lead. So check this out. So let's just run through that. Remember that? All right. That's from the first part, the verse of the song, or the intro. Then, what we do is we go, I use my ring to hold the bottom, the fourth and fifth string down and slide from the third to the fifth fret. And then back down to the third, so slide up. So, it's going to be a slide to the fifth and back down to the third. That's a slide there too. So, and then you're going to take these two fingers, your index and your middle, go up a string with both of those. You're going to be on the fourth and fifth. On your index is going to be on the second fret, and your middle is going to be on the third. So that's a little tricky. All right, so back to here. Once you go here, and you're going to jump here, so you're going to slide first up two frets, and then back down, and then off with your index, and then slide up, and then back down, pull off the index, and then strike. Okay, so it's like this. Get a little closer on that. Oops. All right. So, here's what we got so far. Just like you did on the first time. It's a little different, setup that time. Instead of going, this one's gonna go. All right, then you're gonna bend on the fifth. And you're gonna bend, and then pull off. Then hit back on the fifth, and then you're gonna go down a string, or up a string, fourth string, second fret. Okay? So it's going to be like this. And then a bend. and then a strike on the second, pull that off, and just strike on the fourth string, second fret. Okay, so it should be like this. Alright. And then it's going to go again. So just a different way to play it, a little bit different. And then to G. Alright, so one more time. Here's what we got. Thanks for watching my video, guys. Hope this helps you. Might not be the exact way to play it, but you know, David Gilmour's a master, so you know, we love you, David. Thank you for all your music. He's one of my favorite guitarists out there. Anyways, I hope this helps. The lead is one of my favorite leads to play, and it's a great warm-up lead to get your fingers ready and bendy and bluesy. So, anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. Hope it helps you. Be interested in any feedback you have. Make sure to thumbs up the video and subscribe. And I really appreciate you watching. And we'll see you in the next one.